Now for this example, we're going to look at a function called colorFromHex. This function takes a color represented as an integer, specifically a uint32, or a 32-bit integer. Now we're going to use hexadecimal notation because it's easier to read. You may have seen colors represented this way if you've worked in web design before. When a color is represented with 6 hex digits, like this pink color here, the first 2 hex digits represent the red part of the color. So this CC represents the red part of the color. The next 2 digits represent the green part of the color. And the last 2 digits represent the blue part of the color. So the colorFromHex function is going to use the bitwise AND operator to isolate each of these component parts. It's going to isolate the red part, the green part, and the blue part. That's what's happening with each of these bitwise AND operators here. Then, with the shift operator, it converts the R, G, and B components into a number that's between 0 and 255. Finally, it divides the R, G, B components by 255 so that the number is fixed between 0 and 1, because that's how a UI color is constructed. If you had trouble following that, then don't despair. I've included a fun link here to a video that really captures how red, green, and blue values are combined to create a color. And if you look down here at the bottom where we've called the function, we've actually split out pink into its red, green, and blue components, and then we've printed out the colors that combine to make this pink color.